Hi, this is Cher from Cher's Crafting Boutique. I am going today to make a plaque for the wall. I also have my daughter in the room with me, Kayla. And I haven't done this before, so we're just gonna wing it on screen really and see where it goes. So I'm gonna show you what I have on the table. And to start with, let's move that down to the floor there. I have some felt. This is a 4x4 sheet.
There's scissors.
Good girl, yes, I have scissors. I have a small pair and a larger pair. You use whatever you have. I have a wooden dowel. This is 9mm wide. And I've just made it that slightly bigger over the felt. So it just comes over on both ends here. It was a big long piece, but I've cut it down. Also, I have some netting. It's the more thicker kind, but you can use, like I said, whatever you have lying around. So there's that. I have this that I got off of eBay, and it's like a scarf. Lacy scarf.
It's pink.
It is pink. And these have got like little dangly pieces on.
And it's actually pink as well.
It is. So I don't know if I'm going to use all this, but I've got it all ready just in case. I've got this lacy ribbon here, but it's got like
pink,
a
pink and white.
It is pink and white. And it's got a pink little thin ribbon going through the middle. I have these flowers.
Pink and white.
Yes, pink and these white ones, yes. These are just paper flowers. I got them from AliExpress, as I've explained before in previous videos. I also have these larger pink flowers here. These were also from AliExpress. I have a ribbon. You use whichever ribbon you have, or even if you decide you want to do something a little different, let your imagination go wild. I have some crochet. I also have some pink lace, some gathered lace. This one's got like a shiny look to it. And I also have some voile in two different colours, pink and white. I have my hot glue, just in, well, I will be using hot glue today. So the table is completely full, but I'll work with it. So first of all, I'm going to take this netting and I'm going to just lace it over the top like that. Bring this further down slightly.
You got it.
Yes, I do need to cut it, but first of all, I need to glue it down. Yeah. So I'm just going to bring that over there.
And be careful.
And then just put a thin amount gradually along the top there.
And be careful, don't be burned, because your finger will be burned in your thumb.
Yes, you do have to be very careful. I always forget to say that, you see, because if you're here, then you remind me, don't you?
Yeah.
You do have to be very careful, especially using this, because it's got holes in, so it catches your fingers.
Last one.
Just put some dobs here and there, you don't need to go mad. It's just to secure it down.
Done it.
And there's there. Take all that excess glue off my fingers there. Oh, thank you. That's lovely. Just have my daughter hand over my protective finger. Rubber thing here. Hold on, let me just get all this glue off my fingers. So I'm going to keep continuously doing this all the way round in a very thin amount. Thank you. You're very helpful. Don't touch it, darling, because you haven't got your finger on. You haven't got the little pink finger on, have you? If you want to do it, you can have the pink finger. Yeah? Come here then. You put that on, and I'll put this down, and then you can tap it down for me, can't you? So just keep going all the way around the edge slightly and gluing that down. I think that's it. I think we're done on that bit. We've got to do the bottom bit now.
Yeah.
All the way to the bottom this time, darling. That's it. You did it. Right. And now we're on to this side, so I'm going to just turn it round this way. Just going to put a thin amount, and there you go, honey. Oh, thank you so much for being so helpful.
Is it easy?
It is.
I know it.
It's easy, but it's going to look lovely, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So, there you go. You want to do that again? It, good girl. And this time all the way down to the bottom. That's it, good girl. And now we're doing this bottom bit.
That's tiny.
Mm-hmm.
Now do it longer.
That's it. A little bit more. All the way along, darling.
That's hot.
You okay?
Yeah. I didn't burn.
You didn't burn. It's supposed to protect you, that. Are you alright?
Yeah.
That's good.
It's only moving.
Oh, did you push your hand down?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
It's to be careful.
Now all we're going to do here is cut off the excess. Now I'm thinking. 2 seconds. I'm thinking, do I want to fold that over like that? Yeah, I think we'll take it slightly over the edge first and then we'll cut it. So we're going to put some more glue just along that edge on the other side and then just secure that down. And then we're going to take the scissors.
It's me.
You want me to do it with your scissors, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm just cutting this excess off at the top here. Hope you can see what I'm doing because I'm covering it over with my hand, I think, slightly here. There we are, so that takes that off. Now I've noticed here that this netting has a 2-layer, so I need to slightly pop that on there. Oh, we just pop that down there. Just down there, that'll do. I'll clear that up at the end.
Okay.
So just on this little edge here, I'm just re-gluing.
Be careful, Mum.
Oh, I am, darling. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I think that's secured there. So now we're going to do that all the way round. Just so it gives it a nice cleaner edge on the opposite side there. And then this corner here, as you can see, it just slightly overlaps there. So all I'm going to do is, I'll move this around so you can see properly. Just put a tiny little bit of glue there. You only need a tiny amount and just fold that over. hold it down for a second. There we are. And I'm just going to do all the way down, just like I did at the top there. Keep going until you get to the bottom and just fold this over and secure it. Take my scissors and cut the excess off there. There we are. Just need a little bit more, so I'm going to fold it. That bit doesn't get in the way. And then get the hot glue again and run it across this edge at the bottom here. We'll start here. On this corner. And just fold that over. Right, before I go ahead and do that, I am just going to fold this piece under there. So we are now just folding this piece under so we get the nice smooth corner on the opposite side. So I'm just putting a little bit of glue and pushing that down. And then cutting that excess there. That's all secure. A little bit there that needs secured down. Taylor, you don't have to sit in here, you know, honey, if you want to go and do something else. Right, and then again. All the way up this side. All I'm going to do is again tuck it, so you're literally just tucking the corner part inwards, just underneath, and just putting a little dab of glue there just to tidy up the opposite side when we turn it over. And I'm going to do the same on this side, so you just fold it under. I'm putting a little dab of glue just at the top in the corner and hold that down. Once it's secured, take all of the excess off. You gonna go and do something else, darling?
Yeah.
Alright. I'll see you in a bit. So we have something that looks like this. Move all of these little bits out of the way so I get some more space on this table. And grab a drink of this coffee before it goes cold. When I get crafting, I forget all about it. Right, this is where we're going to put the dowel on. So, this is where you're going to need your ribbon. First of all, move these out of the way a second. You're going to decide on which side you, which end you want to be your top. Now the flowers go this way down, so my top is going to be up here. It depends on what pattern you have. Now all I'm going to do is glue that to the edge. So I'm just going to put some hot glue and run it across the edge here. Make sure it's centered roughly the best you can. Doesn't have to be perfect. Hold that down for a couple of seconds. Right. Now, take this on a rough guide because I'm going to be rolling this, so I need it to be that little bit longer. There we are. So even though these are going to go underneath, I'm still going to burn those edges. Now if you're going to use a patterned one, remember to make sure the pattern's on the outside. You'd be amazed when you get started and you forget yourself, but make sure the pattern, you're only seeing the back of the ribbon, not the front. And decide how far apart you want it to be. And I'm going to have mine roughly there, so I'm just going to put a little bit of glue there first, just so I can secure this down. Only need a dab of glue here because we're going to be rolling it anyway. And there we are. Oh, see? There you go, I just did it myself. Let me just do that again. Pop that back on there. So, now we're going to be rolling it like this. So, I need to be able to put some more glue on there. So I'm going to roll it. And then when I get to the point here, I am just going to put some hot glue down. So then I'm just going to roll it onto there. Hold that down for a couple of seconds. And then we're going to hot glue this so it sits up like that. Just a little line of hot glue there, and then round this way, just so it sits up the way you want it to. And then when you turn it over, you'll have this. So that's ready to be hung on the wall once we finish decorating it. So pop all of this to one side, I don't need the ribbon no more. So now I've got this gathered lace, and what I'm gonna do is stick this under here. Now this bit, let's see, will I put that up there? I don't know, I might. Yeah, I think I will. So we're gonna start we're going to start in the middle up here. Make sure this is round the right way. Yep, it is. So all I'm going to do is pull that down like that. Actually, I'm just going to turn it over. I'm going to start from the back. So I'm just going to run that along that edge there, a little bit at a time. Come to your corners. Make sure when you put your glue down that you slightly gather it, because if you don't, it'll just pucker up and it'll just go the wrong way. So you just put a little bit of glue there. Even though it's already gathered, you still need to slightly gather it a bit more. So you just put in the glue down and pinching it together. And then bringing it down again with the hot glue all the way to the bottom. You don't need to do this all the way around, just make sure you do the corners. So again, we're at this corner, and I'll show you again what I mean. So you can see a bit better. And all you do is take your hot glue, take it around the corner there, bring it round and just pinch it. Around that corner. And that's it. And you do that on each corner. So it gets that nice gathered edge. It doesn't just go the wrong way. Because if I didn't do that, what happened as I go around the corners, it will go like that. And this here would then pucker upwards, so you'd end up with it looking that way instead of flat. Again, around that corner, bring it round and then pinch it. So all the way up this edge here. Thank you for turning on the light. Certainly need it. Coming over very dark all of a sudden. Right, now take that all the way across that edge there. Slightly overlap it to finish it off. And cut off the excess. Make sure that's secure, which needs a little bit more there. We should have something that looks like this so far. Coming together nicely. Get some more coffee. Right, this is where I'm going to get my crochet. I already cut a piece down a little bit longer, but I think, yeah, I'm going to take this through the middle roughly and just glue that down that slightly across the edge there and just secure that down. Again, if you don't have this, you use whatever you have. You do not have to have the same as me to be able to create something like this. You can just use whatever you have, and you only need small amounts of glue, because as you can see all these holes, if you put too much on, you're going to burn yourself. So maybe it's just do it like that. Wherever you can see there's a full piece to glue onto. All the way along, and then we're just going to cut that excess off. Make sure you don't catch your lace. And there we are, as we have so far. Now, I also have, as I showed you before, this lace with the pink ribbon going through. Now I'm going to use that, and I'm going to put that through the middle. So, again, little bits here and there of hot glue, so I'm just going to start that one in the corner there. And just put a little bit of glue. You don't need too much for this. So where that pattern is, where it's solid in the middle there, so all I'm doing is put a tiny bit in the middle. Just to secure that down. Close to the end, I'm going to put that a little bit more so I know it's secured down properly. And then I'm going to cut that excess off on both sides. So this is what we have so far, and I think it's looking really lovely. Now, in a previous video, I made these cameos, and if you go back onto my videos, you'll see them. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop that into the middle there like that, because I think that's going to look super cute. So I'm going to secure that down, and if you want to see how to make these, just like I said, go back to my previous videos. This one doesn't take very long to make, and it's got so, there's not much to make it with really. You don't need to use loads of supplies, so please do go check it out. I'm going to stick this down on here, get some more glue on this first. All I'm doing is securing the back here and popping this down roughly in the middle. Now I'm not even going to secure this piece down because I think it looks quite nice to just lie there loose. So again, this is what we have so far. You could leave it there if you like, but I'm going to add a little bit more. Now I have, as I showed you before, I have this scarf that I got off of eBay. I think it was only £1, it wasn't very much at all, but I love this trim on the end here, and all I'm going to do is cut it along there so then I can sit it along the top here. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that down a bit. So all I'm doing is taking this trim. fiddly. So how much do I need? Take that along there, so I'm going up to here. Just going to keep cutting that along till I get to there. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's about right, double check that. Yeah. So I'm just going to cut that along there. And that's what I have. Now that's the side I need it on. Take off any little excess pieces because it does leave a bit behind. Now, all I'm going to do is literally just attach that to there. So running that across the edge here, a little bit of blue, just to take that little edging we've got here and secure it onto there. So I went slightly over, so I'm just going to cut that excess off. So I no longer need that anymore, so I move that off the table. And here we go, that's what we have. Now I'm going to add, I don't know, let's have a look. Yeah, I'm going to bring this along the bottom here. I'm going to leave it flat, I'm not going to gather it or anything, I'm just going to secure that down there so it matches the top in the collar range. So all I'm going to do is put a little bit of glue, secure that to there. I'm going to do the same as I did before, just put a dab of it here and there because we don't need a lot. Hope you can see what I'm doing. Continue to do this till I get to the end and put a little line along the bottom there. I love this glue gun, but the one thing that is very annoying about it are the feet. They always get caught on lace whenever you're busy doing it. When it gets over hot, and you've been using it for a while, as you've seen on some of my videos, is it doesn't work very well. So anyway, cut off your excess, and this is what we have. Now I'm going to have a look. I don't know if I'm going to add flowers to it yet, so it's just about messing about and taking a look at it. So I no longer need this either, so I'm going to move that out of the way. So, yes, I think I will. I'm going to just cut that. And take two of these. So I've just cut two of these flowers, and all I'm going to do is pop that on there. Now, as I've showed you in a previous video, do not chuck away yet the ends, because you can make other flowers out of them. If you haven't seen that video, please do go check it out. It literally takes seconds to make and they come out really lovely. I'm going to stick one to either side here. Now, I don't know if I'm going to use this tool yet. I mean, I could put a bow at the top. Yeah, I think I will. Well, I'm going to need some thread for this. I'll be back in a minute. Always forget the thread. So I'm just going to take a small amount off there. There we are. And all I'm using is the white tool. I'm not going to use the pink, and all I'm going to do is take it as, I think, roughly there. Yes, so I'm going to take it as big as I think the bow should be, so I'm just taking a guess, and I'm just wrapping that, so that's 3, 4, and then I'm just going to cut it. Now this can be awkward to see with this transparent look, but it can be a pain, and all I'm going to do is just gather it together, layering it a little bit at a time till I get it centered way that I want it to look. So you're literally just folding it like an accordion in the middle. That's all you're doing. And then getting your thread, holding it into the middle there, and then wrapping. Move that down a bit, it's gone a bit off-centred. And you just, once you get it centred again, just wrap it back round and do this a few times. You don't have to do it that many, but and then you just cut off the excess. Get your hot glue, put a little dollop in the middle there, and then I'm just going to stick mine into the middle of where it's going to be hung up. And then I'm going to get one of my pink roses. Cut the stem. Again, I'm going to keep that. Get some hot glue. Stick that direct in the middle of the bow. Now that I have this, I'm going to move these foils first and put this needle away before I end up losing it and find that it ends up in my finger. And I am going to add these ones. And these are just the white ones. Well, they're more of an off white really, and all I'm going to do is, I need 4 of these. I'm going to put one either side of these pink flowers here. Oh, that one came off even better. Right, cut that, keep them, and let's glue these down. So I am just gluing the middle. I'm going to only glue the middle in case you want to add anything, because then that way you have the outer edge to put something underneath. So I only put a tiny amount in the middle there, and then stick that down. I'm going to move this a bit closer there so you can see. And again, just the centre. See, glue is getting over hot again, and that's what it does. It's very annoying. And now I'm going to do the same with these two. Nope, there we are. And it doesn't want to run away from me. So that one goes on there. Like so. And then this one, opposite side. And I think that's enough. I don't want to add anything else to that because I think it'll spoil it. I can see everything I put on, which I don't like to recover, because if you recover, what was the point in putting the layers on in the first place? So I like to be able to see everything I put on, and I can see the felt underneath the netting. Everything's on sure. I'm happy with that. So thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. I also have a Facebook channel now. It's called Cher's Crafting Boutique. We share all different things that we make. It's only new, so I'm looking for as many people to join as possible so we can inspire each other. So please do come along and check that out. So thank you for watching. Bye.